What's good, everybody? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, the biggest Miami Hurricane fan you ever met. Today, we are going to be talking about order of operations. And to start off our topic today, we're going to start with the definition. What exactly is order of operations? And let's write this down. So order of operations is just a way to simplify expressions using a specific order. All right. And this is how we get the acronym PEMDAS, right? So let's just write that out here to the side. And then we're going to talk about what PEMDAS really is, right? Zoom out some. All right. So when we're talking about PEMDAS, it's just an acronym, right? And what it is, we're talking about parentheses, right? And all these that I'm drawing are going to serve as parentheses. Brackets, parentheses, braces, they're all considered parentheses. And this is where we normally start with order of operations, with our parentheses. After we move from parentheses, we go to our exponents. Okay? So just remember that exponents is repeated multiplication. 5 to the second power just means 5 times 5. Then from there, we're going to multiplication. And all these different ways that you see me writing this problem are the different ways you may see multiplication expressed. All right? For multiplication, we move to division. And then we have addition and subtraction, right? So let's go into some practice, because the biggest thing with order of operations is the multiplication and division, and addition and subtraction. So what we want to know is that when we do problems, right, when we're faced with a problem, let's write down example number one real quick. We have 35 minus 18 divided by 3 times 2 plus 5. So when it comes to multiplication and division, we have to understand that we're going to move from left to right. And what that means is whichever operation comes first, after we take care of parentheses and of exponents, whichever comes first, after we take care of parentheses and exponents, we're going to do. So let's look at this example here, right? And what I want to do is just write PEMDAS out to the side so that we just, you know, have it right there for us in plain sight. So when I look at this problem, I notice I don't have any parentheses or any exponents. So the next thing it tells me to do is to multiply. But when we get to that step of multiplication and division, we're moving from left to right. And what we need to understand is that whichever operation comes first, right, we're going to do. So let's just write that out to the side. Do what comes first. Okay. So in this problem, we're going to actually divide. So let's go ahead and actually divide now. So we have 35, and then we have negative 18 divided by 3. That'll give us negative 6, right? And then we're going to rewrite the rest of the problem. Times 2 plus 5. Now at this step, we can now go ahead and multiply. So when we multiply 6 and 2, right, don't forget that 6 is negative, okay? We're going to get 35 minus 12 plus 5. Now, we kind of had the same issue that we just had with the multiplication and division. So when it comes to addition and subtraction, guys, we're going to do this very same thing. Even though PEMDAS, you know, the the A comes before S, right? The addition comes before subtraction. We are going to solve it moving from left to right with these two operations, okay? So what we want to do is actually subtract first, because that's what comes first. So when we subtract 12 from 35, we're going to get 23. We'll bring down our plus 5, and then now we could take care of addition at our last step, and we should have 28 as a final answer. Okay? So just remember, multiplication and division, right? Addition and subtraction. Let's solve it from left to right. Let's try one more problem. All right, so let's scroll down some, and let's try a different problem. Okay. So, wrong color. So in example number 2, we have 2 to the third power minus 5 times 6 plus 4, right? We're going to close those parentheses, and then we're dividing by 2. Okay? Write my acronym one more time. Okay, so unlike the first problem, I noticed something different here. We have an exponent. No parentheses. Well, we do have a parentheses. I'm sorry. We have parentheses, but we also have an exponent. So we're probably going to start off a little different. So let's start off with the parentheses, right? We're going to add 6 and 4. So let's rewrite our problem. We got 2 to the third power minus 5 times 10 divided by 2, right? Took care of our parentheses. There aren't any more now. So we can move on the ladder in PEMDAS, right? We're going to exponents now. And I noticed that I have an exponent of 3. So just remember, it's not 2 times 3, right? No, we're going to take that 2 and we're going to multiply it by itself 3 times. And once we do that, we should have 8 as an answer. And then I'm going to rewrite the rest of my problem. Okay? So now we have 8 minus 5 times 10 divided by 2. So in this situation, we're going to take care of the multiplication first. We have multiplication and division. You guys already know, right? Whichever comes first, moving from left to right, we are going to take care of. So let's multiply negative 5 and 10. So this will be 8 minus 50 divided by 2. All right? And we should know at this step that we're going to take care of the division first before we subtract. All right? So let's see if we could take care of that real quick. So we have 8 minus 25. And for our final step, once we subtract, we should have an answer of negative 17. Okay? So great job today, guys. Remember, when we're doing order of operations, go through your acronym at every step. Remember, multiplication and division, we're going to solve it from left to right. Whichever comes first, we're going to solve. Same thing with addition and subtraction. Thank you guys for joining today. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters, biggest Miami Hurricane fan you ever met.